Today's video will be on oil change, and we will also review the new Shell Helix HX8, which is API SN Plus engine oil. To begin with, we have to gain access to the oil sump, which means we have to get under the car. You will find the drain bolt at the bottom of the oil sump. Suzuki vehicles with K12 engines usually uses 14mm drain bolt. Next, we move ahead towards the oil filter. A lot of different tools are available for oil filter removal. I personally prefer the socket type tool, which really makes the job easy. Replace the old oil filter with a new one. Remember to spread some fresh oil on the top of the O-ring of the new oil filter and then screw it back to its place. Keep note that the torque requirement for this kind of filters is around 16 Nm, which is on lower side, so no need to flex your muscles to work on this stuff. Fix the oil drain bolt back, and if possible, replace the washer every time you open the oil drain bolt. Time to fill the engine with fresh engine oil. 3.1 liters is the recommended quantity for Suzuki K12 engines. This time I decided to go with the Shell Helix HX8, which has got the latest API SN Plus approval. Earlier, I was using the same oil, which was API SN approved. It's been close to a month I'm using this new engine oil. I have done a few highway runs and some serious traffic crawling with the HX8. The 100% synthetic base oil, along with excellent additives, proves their mettle in such situations. But if you are someone like me, who is coming from the previous gen HX8 and wants to experience some difference with the new HX8, then probably you won't. The flexi molecule technology marketed on the new pack was always a part of the previous gen HX8, so that is not new. This engine oil is engineered for better fuel efficiency and to minimize the wear and emissions, which is applicable to almost all API SN and SN Plus engine oils. The primary concern of API SN Plus engine oils is to protect the engine from LSPI, which stands for low speed pre-ignition, which is a weird combustion process mostly observed in turbocharged engines, where the air fuel charge ignites inside the combustion chamber before it is supposed to ignite at TDC. LSPI can severely affect engines by cracking pistons, breaking spark plugs, etc., which can happen due to hot spots created by the presence of engine oil in combustion chamber. Now coming back to the HX8, with viscosity index above 160, the oil performs really well under heavy use and manages to return decent fuel efficiency. I personally found no difference in fuel efficiency when compared to the previous gen HX8 with API SN approval. Time to conclude this video. Do let me know if you want more videos on maintenance and stuff like LSPI. Do share your experience with different engine oils in the comment section.